tunapata sasa hivi, we have ChatGPT. So maybe I want to motivate you first, eh? By maybe showing you something here. Let me share my screen. Okay, so I hope mnaona my screen. Mkiona private information, just ignore. So that is my screen. Okay, so I have an account with Upwork. So this is my account. I hope everybody can see. Let me show you my profile so that maybe unaweza kuwa na at least a little bit of motivation. So before you start coming to this course, mjue what we mean by academic writing, what it can offer, maybe in the short term or a long term. So my name is Edwin. This is my account. So you can see my job success score is 100%. Huku mimi niko top rated among the best. So this is my services. I'm a writer, technical writer, digital marketer. I also write books. I'm a researcher, so I charge $12 per hour. So this is just a bio of my account. So maybe I will share the link later to the WhatsApp group. So I have earned $5,000. So you can multiply that by almost 125. Even the exchange rate size. I have worked for a total of 496 hours. So let me show you the learning contract. So this is a completed job that I have done too. One, I wrote papers and books. One, I transcribed an audio file. So the ones that are in progress right now, they are three. So kuna client fulani hapa, anataka ni muapply a position. Yeah, ni professor na muapply a shule fulani. So amenipa $10 per hour. You see this contract in August 30. That is ilikuwa like 3 days ago, or 4 days ago. And I'm working for 5 hours. I have this one. It was a fixed contract. I earned $70. Nilikuwa na hii book. This is currently ongoing. Nilianza February 18th up to present. Na nime earn $54. So that is my account. So just to confirm that this is my name. I will show you the start and trends. So this is 12 month earning. You can see my jobs are successful. Like signing metuma proposal moja. My current relationship, you can see it's 100%. I'm top rated. So tukisema mambo ya academic writing inakuanga ni something that iko na if you put more effort on it, utaona tangible result. Because kama hii profile yangu, let me show you again. This contract. Where is it? In progress. So hii nimeanza February 18th na ukisema leo tuko mwezi wa ngapi? Mwezi wa tisa. So unaweza hiyo hiyo time kidogo hivyo, the amount that I have earned. So when you umeingia saizi, my name is Edwin. I have done this academic writing for the last 5 years. Nimekuwa nikiandikia wasee wenye wako na accounts, natafuta clients online. Recently nikasema nifungue tu account ya Upwork and I can see iko na very good results. So as I was saying, you are very lucky. Umekuja kusoma hii course when we have AI, ChatGPT. So ChatGPT, mwenye mjatumia, ndawatumia hiyo link kwanza kwa nini kwa WhatsApp so that you can make sure muna familiarize nayo, because without AI these days you cannot survive in this market, because sasa hii mambo ya kujichokesha na kuandika long stuff inakuanga just a waste of your time. So resources ndakuwa natuma kwa this link ya WhatsApp so that you can access it anytime, anywhere and anyhow. So
today, okay, just a minute, feature WhatsApp. Natuonyesha mambo ya WhatsApp.
Mko hapo ndani? That is why I told you to ignore what did we call it? Information kama hizi. Pole pole, acha ni so kidogo tu, kidogo tu. Oh, so I will be sharing one item at a time. So saizi mnaona hii nini? Mnaona this one hii ChatGPT yangu. Maybe you can raise your hand if you unaona hiyo ChatGPT yangu. Sawa sawa. Akiona mko sawa. So that is my ChatGPT. So I'm going to clear what we call it this data. Nilikuwa nafanya kazi zingine hapo. So today nilikuwa nataka before we go into lighting, I wanted you to learn tools that we use in academic writing tools. Before you ushike mkono yako uanze kuandika kwa keyboard, you need some tools. Hizo tools ndio zinakusaidia this kazi unaifanya haraka haraka, so that you can be able to kupata clients haraka haraka and then you serve them very fast. If nimekutumia 10 pages kitambo, we used to take 24 hours unafanya just 10 pages, but with AI unaweza tumia the same type amount of work, unaweza tumia maybe 5 to 6 hours. So this is the first tool that we use in academic writing. So nimewatumia link hapo kwa group. So I will show you how AI inafanyanga. Inakuwa inaitangwa ChatGPT. So ChatGPT inakuwa na a very so many cool features. So unaweza kuja uiambia hapa light an essay about education. And by the way, sitaki muandike mahali na bairo, because kwa academic writing hakuna mahali utaishika bairo uandike nayo. So if uko na notebook, throw it away. Ndio maana watumia links kwa group, because I want you to practice using your computer, because anytime unachukua kalamu unaandika kwa kitabu inakufanya ukue slow na machine. You need to be very fast with those keyboards. You must know how to navigate your touchpad and everything. So write me an essay about education. Unasema send. So this is how cool AI is, inakuambia the role and importance of education in a modern society. So wewe tu unakaa hapo chini unaweka chai unangojea ifanye kazi yake. Fanya kazi yake hivyo 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 hivyo. Okay, so after umemaliza hapo, wacha imalizie kunini kulight, all. So unakuja una copy this content. Hapa kuna tools za kukopi, hizi ziko hapa, but I prefer ukopi hivyo. So today najua mna laptop, so wengi wenyu you just wanted to see how the program is, but next time tukipatana I would prefer ukuwe na laptop yako, so that you can follow me venye nafanya. So next time mkuwe na laptops, this session tutarudia kidogo kidogo, so that mkuwe ready na mkuwe na nini. So unaenda una kwa Microsoft Word. So I should be sharing my screen. Waya tu ni share screen yote. I'm assuming hakuna kitu hapa ya kuona mbaya. Hakuna. Ikuwe rahisi. Just 1 minute, I share my screen.
Okay, as you do that, I had seen a hand was up. Faye, you had a question? Faidiaka, you can unmute and ask the question.
Okay. Feyo, ukona swali? Okay, in case you have a question, utainua mkono tu tena. I hope now you can see my screen. Peter, can you see my screen? Yeah?
Yes, I can see it.
So tumeenda ChatGPT. That is the first tool ya academic writing. First tool ya academic writing tumesema ni ChatGPT. Na tumekuja tukakuja tukakopi kenye tunataka kufanya hapa. Kuambia tuambia an essay about education. This is the essay. Unakuja hapa copy Microsoft Word hapo. That is why I'm telling you mkuu na computer, because shortcut ya kupaste ni Control V. So basically this is a essay yenye tumeenda tukatafuta huko kwa ChatGPT. But there is something kwa academic writing inaitangwa plagiarism. What is plagiarism? And before I go to plagiarism, maybe I want maybe to give you a recap of what academic writing is. Because I'm assuming at some point in your life, you have done assignment in schools, mumena mkafanya assignment, umeambu ufanya hivi, but ukaenda kwa cyber, ukanunua full scope, ukaandika, and you submitted the assignment. So that was writing, but it was not formal writing. So academic writing, it is a form of formal writing. What do I mean by formal writing? It has a specific structure of how you submit your work. You must have a title, you must have the body, and must have the reference. So that one, tutakuja tuongee nayo baadaye, because najua the other lesson mtakuwa na computer zenyu. So today, na Peter, if you see somebody raising their hand, you can tell me because I'm out of that screen.
Okay, no problem.
Sawa. So today nataka niwaonyeshe vitu zile two basics because hiyo mambo ya structure of the papers tutakuja later. So the first tool of academic writing nimewatumia kwa link, that is ChatGPT. So the next tool of academic writing inaitangwa plagiarism checker, because huwezi submit kazi kama umekopi kwa ChatGPT, because hiyo ni copying somebody else's work. So you cannot submit a work that is copied. So when you go to your browser, unaenda una search 0GBT.com. So this is just a free tool. Along the way nitaonyesha ile premium tool yenye tunatumianga ile inaitangwa Tantin, but for now I will show you kidogo hii mambo ya 0GBT, and then as we go ahead with the program nitakuja niwaonyesha zile advanced, zile premium versions of plagiarism checkers, ukuje utumie uone kama your work has plagiarism. So let me send you this to the group again. So that is that one is called 0GBT. So just to demonstrate what is 0GBT. 0GBT, it is a self-explanatory thing. 0GBT. GBT is the AI. It is a tool that we used to search. So inaangalia kama kenye uko nayo, it has 0GBT. So you come to your Microsoft Word like that, Control A, Control C, copy. Unakuja hapa kwa 0GBT, una paste. And then unasema detect text. So hapa itakuja ikuambie your text is AI or GBT generated 99.49%. So if I'm a student niko America, nimekupatia kazi, umeenda ChatGPT ukanitumia ikiwa na AI, I will not pay you, and maybe if you kona account I will have it blocked. So up to that point, do we have any question? Maybe you can raise your hand and ask that question. And those that are new, maybe tutaenda nitarudia kidogo some of the things. So if you have a question, maybe you can ask me. Tumeenda kwa tools of checking whether the content has been generated by the AI. So these are the tools of academic writing. Tumeanza na ChatGPT. Tumesema hii ChatGPT, this one, inatumika ku search for information, whatever that you need. Uliza anything, as long as it has it in its memory, iko nayo. Na I would love you people to ignore zile vitu mnasikenga za academic writing, mambo ya nini, mambo ya AI. Don't listen to those people. Let me teach you how these things are done. Because kitambo, tulikuwa tunakuja, tukisearch, eh? Tulikuwa tunaenda kwa Google Chrome, eh? Tuna search information, kama ni mambo ya, hii essay tumeandika hapa ya the role and importance of education in modern society, nigeenda kwa Chrome, ni search hapa. Let me try to search that one, eh? The role of Chrome, eh? The role of something. So nikuja hapa ni, I paste there. Na ukiangalia itakuletea vitu mingi hapa. So the role of education, the role and importance of education in modern society. So kitambo tulikuwa tuna search hivi. So ningekuja hapa hii kazi ni so many like the way you did in assignment, unaenda una paraphrase. But now what AI does, inatumia it powers zenye sijui maybe Peter ata explain baadaye. I'm not a tech person. AI inaendanga to those different websites, the million of them, inachukua details moja. So hata ukiambia usitumie AI alafu wewe uone ni mjanja uende utumie Chrome, you'd still get the same information. Maybe tukuje hapa kwa hii data tuone hivyo. We'll come to that later. So useme wewe umekuwa mjanja ukaenda kwa Chrome ukatafuta, ukileta hapa bado itakuletea iko na plagiarism still, eh? So whichever the way, bado utajipata pale. So we don't have a question so far, so maybe I'll still go forward. So tumeenda kwa tool number one of tumeanza na academic writing. What is academic writing? Tumesema academic writing, it is a formal writing. Si ile ya kuchukua full stop unaandika unatumia lecture. Hapana, it is not form, it is not that manual. It is a formal writing. Si kama ile nyingine ya kitambo yenye una without a heading, without something, without a body, and without references. So either to mambo ya references and bodies, I will come to teach you when we come to the structures of these papers now. That was where are we? We are to go up kwa AI detector. So your content tumeenda kwa nini ChatGPT, tukaenda tukakuja tukaweka hapa kwa 0GPT, links ziko kwa nini kwa WhatsApp, eh? Tukasema detect text, ikasema hapa the text is AI or GPT generated. So how do we remove that AI ikuwe iko zero? Number one, unakuja kwa document, eh? I hope you can still, Peter, can you see the document clearly?
Yes, the document is clear. I don't know who is using the phone and what the challenge they are facing.
Okay, we'll have a link up of this some other time, eh? Because it is something we'll be doing on a continuous basis, eh? So today today we don't want to type, because if you want to remove AI from this thing, eh, unaweza kuja unasema unaiweka hivyo, unasema education is a cornerstone of human development and society progress, unakuja unaandika in your own words. But we are not going to use that one for today. Leo nitaonyesha zile online methods za kutoa hizo vitu zinaitangwa AI. So tool number three, unaenda kwa Chrome hapa una search stealth, and by the way, stealthwriter.ai. Nimewaambia hizi vitu kuna premium versions of the same. So right now tutatumia zile free, za zingine hazikuwangi accurate, so we'll use these free platforms for now, and then after some time tutakuja sasa nikiwafundisha kutumia zile premiums polepole. Hizo premiums zinauzango, but as long as you are in a community of writers, mtu ananunuanga and then you share amongst yourself. So hii inaitangwa Stealth the Writer. Inakuanga inahumanize AI to human content. So for just demonstrations, we are not going to take the entire document. It has a limit of 300 words because it is a free version. So unakuja unakopi kakitu kama anga kadogo hivyo. Nimetuma hiyo link kwanza. Let me first send you that link kwanza nisahau. Stealthwriter.ai. Hapa kwa group, where is that group? So easy links, you can just copy them and book work document unazi bookmark unazitumia pole pole. So tukuje kwa hii word document, we say you just cut hivyo, unakuja hapa, you paste here, and then you say humanize. Itakuletea another new tab, utakuja hapa, control V. So education is a cornerstone of human development and societal progress. It is a transformative tool that shapes individual lives, drive economic growth, foster social cohesion, and support innovation and creativity. That is according to ChatGPT. Now, we want to remove that AI and we want to humanize this content. Na mtu mwenye kwa shule, maybe if you like lecturer wako akushike, you can use this method. Kama you are submitting your academic papers online. So if you humanize, utakuja itakuletea results up. I hope, Peter, can you see this screen?
Yes, I can be able to see it.
So we have your new undetectable content. Find the most undetectable draft, humanize more, check for AI. So, unakuja hapa, unashika, find most undetectable draft. So, this is the most undetectable draft. Unakuja, unakopi hapa. Unakuja first let's return ile ilikuwa iko na AI, hiyo ilikuwa na AI, this was the one that had AI, and then I'm going to paste this one that is bolded yenye imetolewa AI. So education is a cornerstone of human development and societal progress. So hii ingine imekuja ikasema aje juu imeleta human. Education is the lowest foundation of man as well as the society. It can be reborn into such an indispensable element. So ukisoma hiyo kitu unaona it doesn't make sense, unarudi hapo kwa this detector, unatafuta another draft. So hiyo yenye tumechukua ukisoma unaona it make sense hata kidogo. So if you see something does not make sense, just leave it. So unakuja unachukua draft 2, unakuja hapa kwa unaachana na hii, unaweka hiyo draft 2. This is a free version eh? Na ndio unaona sasa iko na errors kidogo kidogo, unaona it makes sense, but if you use now the premium version yenye sina saa hizi, utapata the content is more in a flow not an uki compare na hii. So this one sasa ndio ile tumechukua ya pili. Hebu tuone hapa ama kuna kitu nimeacha. This is draft 3. This is draft 9. So, hii nasema education is the cornerstone of human development and societal progress. Na hii nasema education is the key for human development, for any society to grow to its desired potential. I hope mnaweza sikia difference. Hii nasema education is the cornerstone of human development and societal progress. Hii nasema education is the key to human development, for any society to grow to its desired potential. It is a transformative tool that shapes individual lives, drive economic growth, foster social cohesion, and support innovation and creativity. Hii ingine inasema, it is an agent of change, that is education, that defines individual lives, contribute to economic development, promote unity in the society to advance ideas and creativity. So, maybe just to confirm whether hii content iko na still na AI, unakuja una copy first, unaenda kwa the other tool inaitwa 0GBT. Where are you 0GBT? Trusted AI checker, tuone kama itakuja ilete hiyo content. So you remove yenye iko hapo kwanza, and then tuangalie the amount of AI yenye iko hapo ndani. So tumesema to detect text, alafu hapo chini imeleta your text is now human written. So saizi ukitumia hii nini hii text lecture atasema hey, kijana huyu ni mwelevu sana, but in real sense you have just used your mind. Kutype your paragraph with your hands ungetumia roughly 30 to 40 minutes as a beginner. Mimi nitatumia 10 minutes But sasa because tumetumia AI, tumetumia 5 minutes. So you can see how you're saving your time, your energy, and your head. Kitu wao tumia mali pengine si kwa mambo ya academic writing. Here we are just here to make money. So hii imesema your content now is human written. So ukirudi hapa kwa this document, so we have this now, we have this and this. The first one and the second one. So first of all, I'm going to ignore the e-document ingine because to save time, let me just remove this one just for demonstration purposes. So tumesema education is a cornerstone of human development and societal progress. It is a transformative tool that shapes individual lives, drives economics. Hii ingine imekuja na mambo yake. Na tumepeleka pale kwa 0GBT, ikasema your content is 0GBT. So ukiona hii time yenye tu nini, hii time yenye utumii keyboard kutype, it doesn't mean that utaenda usearch something alafu usi, what do we call it, uenda usearch kitu alafu usisome. So you must read and make sure ina make sense. So for now today tutasoma, tomorrow we need to make sure whether this information that hii kitu imeleta hapa, whether it is making sense. As much as it has 0GBT, you must make sure the information that is written there, it is making sense according to whatever you are looking for. So for demonstration purposes, let me just remove this one. Hii ndio yenye tumeenda kwa pale kwa GBT tuka change. So we have so far we have 3 tools of academic writing. Tools zile za kutumia, usi type, don't type fast. We are going to show you first the tools because saa zingine unapatanga an assignment, it is due 1 hour, another one it is due 30 minutes and unataka kuifanya haraka haraka. So tool number one, just recap, it was ChatGPT. ChatGPT mwenye hajakuwa huku hivi ndani tumesema ni ChatGPT, unakuja you just ask it anything. What is Newton second law of motion with examples? Examples inakuja inakuambia, hii ni kitu mrefu sana, inatumia a lot of data, inaenda huko kwa what do we call them, website, inachukua information zote. So hii inakuletea Newton law of motion hapa, hata unafanya lecture akuwe mjinga, because sasa akiona vitu kama hizi atashangaa, kijana kwani which mind are you using So utaenda kwa online upate mtu anakona assignment anakuambia, can you search for me about Newton, sijui, don't even usitaki kujua what is that, go to the internet, search it, hata kama it is not your field of profession, because I know hapa kuna engineer, we have somebody who is in humanities, we have somebody who is in computer science, we have another person who is in hospitality, but anybody anaweza andika, because mimi, like me, my profession is in finance na nafanya hizi mambo ya ese bado. So this is Newton second law of motion. Let me allow poem. This is ChatGPT. Na wenye wameingia saa hizi nimewaambia, msiambiwe ati ChatGPT ni mbaya. What ChatGPT does, inachukua information from different search engines. Na hii ingine kenye inafanyanga, what does it do? Inachukuanga information from just specific. Ukienda kusearch na Chrome itakupeleka just one place. So that is a poem in the quiet, I'm not a poet, so I will just read. In the quiet of the midnight air, I whisper dreams to the moon of days when your hand, so stuff like that. So another thing, what is economics? Oh, what is economics? Economics is a social, what is the video you don't need to know. Ukiwa na ChatGPT inakufanyia hivyo vyote, and you can command it as much as you want. So let me just demonstrate to you further. When you you unaiongelesha kama venye unaongea na mtu, ChatGPT iko na akili na sikilizanga mtu. So imeandika hivyo, let me stop it, niambie I don't like this answer. please be more specific. Economic is a study of people. So now it's trying to be more specific in what? In whatever I've asked it. So neza kasirika tena niambie, because stucky point, academic writing, we don't bullet, we don't do, but I will come to teach you in another time. Niambie, what about you write, can you please write this in block form? So ukiambia write in block form, umeambia yachane na story of, weka bullets, iandike na paragraph. Na academic writing atuwekangi bullets, ukiweka bullets, kazi inarudishwa, unaambiwa ulipe tena. So sasa tumeambia hii nini? Ifanye kitu inaitangwa bullets, itumie bullets. Isitumie bullets. So usiona sasa tofauti. So usitumie hii copy. Tumia just copy like this. Hiyo copy ingine, in your own free time, go and try to use that copy, and then you'll see whatever I'm telling you. Kwa nini sijakwambia utumie copy? So that is the first tool. Unakuja kwa Word. That is, these are the, for the people who have just logged in. Unakuja kwa Word. So this Word, unakuja where is that Word document? Control V. That is a document. Inaongea mambo economics. Tukasema that is the first tool of academic writing. Tukasema the second tool, inaitangwa, links ziko kwa group, inaitangwa 0GBT. So, hiyo inakujanga, inaangalia whether your content iko na something that tunaitanga AI. What is it? Unajua, labda kuna mtu wapo namuambia AI. Anadhani AI inamaanisha aina noma. Si aina noma, ni artificial intelligence. So, una detect text. Ukidetect text, inakuambia your content is 100% generated. So ni kumaanisha umeibia. So if umeibia, na wewe ni mtu mjanja, umeona shule, that is I have taught you, you'll know how to remove that AI. Just to demonstrate, let me just remove this other information, because ile tool tunatumia next. That is the second tool. The third tool inaitangwa Stealth Writer. What is Stealth Writer? Stealth Writer in a humanize AI content, inaifanya ikuwe human content, yani inaweka ushamba nani. Unajua that is, ukisikia mambo ya human, inamaanisha inaweka ushamba. Unajua ukiweka ushamba ndio inaleta grammatical errors hapo ndani. So unfortunately I cannot hear you laugh, but I know you are smiling whenever you want. So unakuja, sorry, wenye si nimeenda mbio hapo, you come una paste kwa hii nini, alafu unafinya hapa humanize. So these things are the things that you should practice pole pole. So hapa unakuja unayambia, it give you the most undetectable draft. Unakuja una copy hapo, unarudi kwa 0GBT tena. So first go you to your Word document, Control V, this is your new document. Unakuja unafinya Control Evo, Control, what do we call it? Control, tunaangalia kama iko na AI tena. So we just copy this. Hii imetoka kwa Stealth Writer. So is the data imechange that human content, no, artificial intelligence, aina noma content, ikakuja ikaifanya to human written. So unakuja hapa inaitangwa 0GBT. So tukuje tuangalie kama hii content kama iko na AI. Ukipata iko na AI, you just try until it removes the AI. So because rangi imesema your text is now human written. So hii kazi ukikuja ukinisubmitia, I will still pay you your money, kwa sababu utaona kazi yenye umeniandikia haina AI. Nikakwambia ukitumia Stealth Writer, because inaweka ushamba, make sure you read that information again, uone kama ina make sense, because tunaweza sema this is a woman, alafu yende iseme woman is this. So that is not right. So go and read that document. Although we are going to focus more on this as we are going forward, So unakuja unasoma economics is divided into two branches. Ile tukikuja hapa kwa nini ilikuwa inasema, what was it saying hapa kwa ChatGPT? Economic is a study of how people, businesses and this and this. So tuko wapi? So hii ndio haina nini. Economics is divided into mean they are micro and macro. That is, mimi nimesoma economics, I know that is true. Microeconomics on the other deals macroeconomics. So microeconomics on the other side deals with decision making by smaller units like individual firms and special market. So ukisoma una make sure ina hizo vitu utakuja kuangalia baadaye. So right now hatutaenda sana into that because I know most of you don't have your laptop, but next time kila mtu akikuwa na laptop yake mta log in, we will do it together as I demonstrate in the screen. So far we have three tools, links mko nazo zote. So another link, another tool that we have inaitangwa paraphrasing tool. So that is the tool number 4. Unakuja hapa kwa Google Chrome, unatafuta Peter, I hope my screen is still visible. Paraphrasing tool. Hello? Paraphrasing tool. Unasema paraphrasing tool. Can you raise your hands? Niona kama mko. Just one person or two. Yeah, I can see you all there. So,
yeah, so okay. Before maybe you continue, Edwin, are there any questions with regards to how far we have come so that now we don't sizipote in between?
They just note them somewhere. Pole pole. Kuna time unaweza nipigia simu, unaweza shika zingine nisishike, unaweza nitumia kwa WhatsApp yangu, unaweza ni call personally, uniulize maswali. My number is there, you can always call me and I will make sure I explain. But Peter, because I know they don't have laptops today, either maswali next time we will appreciate them more, because ataniuliza swali and then nitamuonyesha practically on how they are going to tackle that challenge. So we are in the tool number 4 in itangwa paraphrasing tool. So unakuja inaitangwa hii, this free paraphrasing tool, this one. Let me send you the link. Inaitangwa Quillbot. So hizo vitu zote nimewaonyesha hapo, we have now the premium version. Hii tunatumia ni free. So what do I mean nikikwambia ni free? Free inamaanisha, that one might be a very big link. If it doesn't work, you tell me, I'll send you another one. Free inamaanisha it has a limit of the number of words that you can use. Kama this one inaitangwa paraphrasing tool iko na limit. Ile premium you can do up to 1,000 words. Hii unaweza fanya only 300 words. So there are some features ukitumia that link. The features are self-explanatory. You have the standard version. Hapa unaguza standard, unaguza fluency, unaguza natural, formal. Unaona kama hii imefungwa, so you go to premium. So natural haiko hapo. So for today purposes, we are going to use this feature inaitangwa fluency. Fluency. So unakuja hapa kwa document, control A, control C. So hizo vitu zinaonyesha polepole, alafu ukitumia kompyuta yako utajifunza tu polepole. So let me just cut for the purpose of demonstration. Nikuja ni paste hiyo kitu hapa hivyo. Imekuja hapa ikasema go to the premium version because nimeweka 141 words na limit ni 125 words. So tukuja hapa tena this one. So let's just ignore this document. Don't save. Let's use this one. Inakaa kidogo hii education. So unakuja hapa you cut. Unakuja kwa paraphrasing tool. Let me not just cut it, muone difference. So I'll just copy like that, alafu nikuja hapa kwa hii inaitonga paraphrasing tool Quillbot, si French, Quillbot, control V. Hii ni 106 words imetoshea. So we are going to use the standard version. Hii standard version hii ndio inabadilisha majina kabisa. Alafu hapa ukiona kuna synonyms. You can increase the synonyms hapa hivi, or you can decrease the synonyms hapa hivi. So what are synonyms? Synonyms, watu wenye walisoma Kiingereza high school, but it is not a requirement ukuwa ulisoma Kiingereza, so don't shy off eh? Synonyms are words that sound similar to each other. So a girl and a boy, it is not a synonym. I don't know what that is, but synonym ni zile vitu zenye zinaendanga, they have different word, but they are pronounced differently. So examples of synonyms, we'll tackle them in the next class. So unakuja hapa unasema standard, unafinya hapa replace. Unakuja hapa unafinya copy, unakuja hapa unafinya control V. So hii ni kitu tumeenda kwa paraphrasing tool, tukachange kitu inaitangwa standard. Standard imeleta synonyms. Ni kumaanisha kitu kama, let me find one synonym. Peter, do you know any of one synonym, uniambie? Kiingereza yangu ni poor. Synonym.
Come again.
Do you know an example of a synonym? Majina ina sound the same lakini, you know, ina mean the same lakini ya isi.
I think my internet is facing an issue.
So let me just 1 minute niweke flight mode. Unanisikia sasa?
Yes, I can hear you.
Sawa. Tulikuwa hapa kwa synonyms eh. So hiyo tutakuja kuongea baadaye juu mimi mambo ya Kiingereza hapana. Ama later but mambo ya Kiingereza hapana. So hii document this one hii tumeichukua tu a tool inaitwa paraphrasing tool. Paraphrasing tool ikabadilisha. Imesema education is the cornerstone of human development and societal progress. Na hii ikakuja ikasema the foundation of both individual growth and society advancement is education. So ni kama vector ni ile unasema point A to point B, unaweza pitia point C uende B, lakini hii nayo unaweza pitia the other way. So ni ku change sentence structure, such things. So inakuja inasema it is a transformative instrument that improves social dimension. Hii nyingine, it is a transformative tool that shapes individual lives. So if you read these two things, they are different but they mean the same. So that is the power of a paraphrasing tool. So paraphrasing tool hiyo ni standard. So we can still copy this again. Just copy it again. Ukuje hapa kwa paraphrasing tool, you use this one that we call fluency. So fluency ni kama uongeleshwe na mwalia Kiswahili usielewe na mwingine kuongelesha uelewe. So fluency ni ku make sure inafuatana vizuri. So unafinya hapa the phrase. So una kwa fluency sasa imeka fluency. It is the same information, but now this one is more fluent. Unakuja unafinya control V. So let's read all of them. Education is the cornerstone of human development and societal progress. That is the first line. Number two, to make a standard, it may change the synonyms. The foundation of both individual growth and societal advancement is education. Hii ingine tumeweka kitu inaitangwa fluency, ikasema nayo education serves as the foundation of both individual and society advancement. If you read those three statements, they all mean the same, but hizo statements zote utakuja upate ziko na some different tone eh? Unaisikia yani iko na tofauti. So utatumia lecturer hii asome aseme huyu jamaa Kiingereza yake yako sawa, umwambie lecturer tulia, unakimbia pale kwa paraphrasing tool teketeke, unaenda unaweka fluency, unamtumia, unapata yeye yako. That is ile unafanyanga shule, but kama ni student unaenda unamtengenezea vizuri kazi yake, anaenda anapata yeye yake, and then you get your money. So that is how we go about the fourth tool of academic writing, that is paraphrasing tool. What it does, it paraphrase. Through the upper paraphrasing tool, I hope you can see my window. So umeona hii side kuna words za black, the other side we have red and we have blue words. So what does that mean? Ukiona a blue word in a paraphrasing tool, know that word iko na kitu inaitangwa plagiarism. Inamaanisha hiyo hii kazi ukipeleka pale kwa AI detector, you will still get some AI content. So what you do, unakuja na kasa yako ya mouse, unaguza transformative, inakupatia another word, unakuja unaweka fundamental, inaweka red, that means it's okay. Unakuja from, unakuja unasema according to, sawa, ina change color. Unakuja kwa earliest, unasema the simplest or the most primitive, you tumia Kiingereza, the most primitive, inatoa hiyo color black, inaweka color red, ama inaweka, so black and red is good but blue it is not good. So ukipeleka kazi hapa unaguzaguza hivyo Asian cultures, needs, the demands, changing human population, shifting, affects, influences. So hapa ndio tuna change sasa hizo synonyms. So these are the synonyms that I was talking about, eh? So this is just for demonstrations. So before uchukue hii kazi hapa uipeleke to the other side, make sure the content of this thing, eh, yote ni colored, sio blue. Una make sure at least ume change, change. If kuna blue, just one yenye haina synonym ama yenye it makes sense. So that is how pia una make sure unapata the right English or the right tone of your work. So that is what, that is now the fourth tool yenye tumesema inaitangwa Quillbot ama inaitangwa paraphrasing tool. So having said that, let's go to the fourth tool. You might read this thing, upatie mwalimu wako akupatie A, aseme this kazi yenye umefanya hapa iko grammatically correct. Well, it is not grammatically correct. You'll still find hapa ndani kuna mashida na grammar. So tuende hapa kwa ChatGPT. I want us to get another document. What do we ask it? Let ask it. It will be the history of Kenya from independence. And because I told you AI, artificial intelligence, it is very bright, eh? You can command it, ikupatie whatever you want. Tell it, write for me 2000 words and above. Na juu sisi zote, I can see watu wengi hapo ni Zakayo hapo ndani, watu wa Ruto, tuseme, don't mention Ruto anywhere in this statement. Don't mention Ruto. This is AI. Let's see whether itakubali omeno ama itakubali. The history of Kenya from independence. So you just sit, uweke kahawa yako, uweke chai tumandazi hapo, and then let AI do the work for you. Nimeambia isiguze Ruto mahali. We still check whether imeweka hiyo jina mahali. Because yeah, sometimes it can make errors, sometimes it cannot make an error. So una make sure you confirm whether artificial intelligence uki command. That is why you must really read whatever you research. If umeambia don't do this, you must really go sit down, because the qualities of a good academic writer, number one, lazima kwanza una make sure you love reading your work, proofreading your work. Read it one time, two times, make sure everything is correct before you submitting. Because afadhali uanguke the solution, instead utumie mtu client kazi apate uko na grammatical errors. Grammatical errors zinakuanga ni kitu inaitangwa iko na aibu sana. So AI is still doing its work, eh? So tuko kwa era of Mwai Kibaki, the push for multi-party democracy. So these things kitabu ungezia hii kitu, for you just to get these things, eh, ungeenda utafute sana. Just before you search 2000 words kitabu kwa Google Chrome, kwa Google utakaa sana, because you really have to get segment of information, put it together, uipeleke pole pole, uipeleke pole pole. And one thing, eh, Google is not always right. Bado ChatGPT kwangi always right. You Google tender will release a site of pregnancy, and then where? Utasikia uko na mimba hata kama wewe ni mwanaume, because most of the time inakuambianga whatever you want to know. So always make sure unasoma kila kitu yote. So this AI nimeiambia aje ikuje iongee mambo ya Kenyan independence hivyo hivyo. Inasema continue generating. Hapo ilikuwa haiko imefika mwisho. So nikaiambia you continue generating because ilikuwa imechoka. So let's see mpaka ifikishe hapo. Hata hapa kuna handshake between Kenyatta and Odinga in 2018 than expected. So we go forward and we go forward. I can see we are coming to the end of our lesson, but let me just conclude this one thing to make sure, at least tomorrow, make sure the next day we meet, come with a laptop. So imeandika hivyo. So I can ask it a question. Have you mentioned Ruto anywhere? Ruto anywhere? Itakuja ikuambie, no, I didn't mention William Ruto, Kenya current president and former deputy president in the summary. If you want me to include information about Ruto and his role in the Kenya post-independence history or recent political development, please let me know. So saizi imesema ijaandika, but I still cannot trust it. Unaona, hapo imesema it has not written anything about William Samoei Ruto, the hustler. So we come and copy this information like that. Tukuje hapa kwa Word document. Ikukuje ukafinya control V. So imekuletea information yote. This is 1841 words. Tuko tumeiambia ituandikie from 2000 words going forward. So if at all ningeenda hapo ningeiambia kama if at all I was doing a work, ningeiambia make sure the word is 2000 and above. So we want to make sure kama AI imesema ukweli, kama imeweka Ruto ndani. So what we will do, unafinya control. Sasa hizo unajua mna laptop, utakuja kuonyesha. Control F, unakuja una search hapo William Ruto, una search Ruto. If ukisearch Ruto, imetuletea tu option moja. In 2013, Uhuru Kenyatta, the son of Jomo Kenyatta, was elected president with William Ruto. The statement is true, it omit Ruto from Kenya independence. So that is the power of AI. That is what it does. Utayambia itoe Ruto, but because it knows Ruto is the right man in the history of Kenya post-independence, itamweka hapo basi, because for it to give you the right answer, lazima you make sure William Ruto wako hapo. So we have one result of Ruto here. And it was just, that one was just to demonstrate how AI can do it work. So as about the part, let's just sample something of you. During Kenyatta presidency, Kenya undertook several large-scale infrastructure projects such as the construction of the standard gauge railway. Yani, inakuwa ikijua kila kitu. So this information imeenda kwa government website ya Kenya, ikachukua kidogo, ikaenda pale kwa SGR kidogo kidogo, ikaenda kwa bawe ya nani hapo hivyo, ikachukua kidogo kidogo, ikaenda hapo, alafu ikaicombine that information is one. So we were going to the fifth tool, if I'm not wrong, of academic writing. Hiyo tool inaitangwa Grammarly. Grammarly, I will type it here. Grammarly, hiyo I have a premium version. That one I also have a premium version because Grammarly ndio natumianga sana kwa hizi kazi. So let me send you the link. So Grammarly ni ya kukuonyesha so there it is, https grammarly.com. So those things mtaitumia, mnaweza chukua mziweke kwa, what do we call it, mziweke kwa Word document, just mkuu unaziona hapo, you just copy and paste before computer yako izoee, itakuwa inazileta vizuri. So we go to Grammarly. So what is Grammarly? Grammarly, ukienda kwa ChatGPT ama ufanya kazi yako udhani wewe ni mwelevu sana, you have written your own English. Sasa Grammarly inaenda hapo inakuonyesha, my friend, ujafanya kitu. So this is Grammarly, this is the premium version. Ukiangalia hii Grammarly utaona leading with resilience, nursing and what to eat. This is a paid version, so it means kuna watu wengi wamenunua and we are sharing this Grammarly. So hizi kazi tunaona hapa, hizi ni watu wengine wanafanya. So one rule of Grammarly, if I give you the premium version, if I tell you to buy the premium version from another person, I will give you their contact at the end of the training. Ukinunua Grammarly, ukienda hapo, don't, sinuna hapa kuna option ya delete, don't delete somebody else work. Because ule mtu wako hapo ndani nafanya kazi yake, anatoa era zake, so ukimdeletia, anarudi from scratch. So because I don't want to interfere with the other people's work, nitakuja hapa niseme new. Okay, you can still upload, eh? When the document we save, we upload from the document. So that is easy. I don't know whether I should save. And so let me save, eh? Just for demonstration purposes. File, save as. So I want to save it in my document, the history of Kenya past independence. Let me just retain that name. So tukuja hapa kwa grammar. My internet is a bit slow, but it is okay. So tukuja hapa, you upload, eh? Uki upload, unakuja hapa kwa documents. So these things, eh, mkona laptop. That is why I need somebody to have a laptop. That is why you cannot learn academic writing with your phone, no matter how hard you try. So the history of Kenya from independence, you just copy the, you just upload that document. I know you have applied for so many jobs, eh? So you know the process of uploading those things. Uko kwa website, eh? So this is how we upload. Uki upload, unagojea grammar ifanye kazi yake. So set goals. So what are we doing here? We want to write an academic something. So this, you say academic type of paper, you say it is an essay, and then you say done. So your document yet, we thought it was so good, but you can see review suggestions, it has 39 errors. So kuna correctness, kuna clarity, we have engagement, we have delivery, we have style guide. So unaguza hivyo, unasema accept, dismiss. In any option, like accept, you just dismiss, accept. So this is grammarly. That is why nikutumia email utashangaa ujamaa kwani hii Kiingereza ametoa wapi. No, it's not my head, my friend. I cannot use my head to earn money. You just use the tools that you have been given by the internet. So you say accept, you say accept, you say accept. So unaona hizi zenye 27 zinaenda zikipungua hivyo hivyo. Accept. So just to be clear, I'm teaching you this academic writing, but we have articles. In this program, we are going to teach you academic writing and articles. So to differentiate between an article and an academic writing, so to me, some academic writing in formal. Why am I saying it is formal? I'm saying it is formal because it has a certain structure. You have the heading, you have the foot, you have the page numbers. I'm going to teach you that later, how you put your body, how you reference your work, how you are supposed to save that document. That is academic. We have articles. Umeenda kwa website pale, google.com, ukaenda uka search ways of... I'm trying to find something, eh? So hapa imeleta hapa, unaona ina suggestions imeisha, imeniambia bravo, there are no more suggestion, great job. So unakuja hapa, unarudi nyuma kwa grammar. Hizi vitu I will teach you practically next time, eh? When you watakuwa na laptop, when you watakuwa wamejoin, we'll teach you practically. So the history of independence, the history of Kenyan independence, unakuja hapa, you download. Okay, download that document. Because the document ukiacha hapa unafanya hapa hii ni kama liter bin, eh? So unakuja una delete hii document kwa grammar isumbue watu wengine wanafanya kazi. And then so that is my download. So nikuja kwa downloads, where are my downloads? Let me go there. Downloads, the history of Kenyan independence. So this is now ile imepitia grammar. So if you follow those steps zenye nimekuambia uende grammar, alafu uende search something, you put it to grammar, then you read the different two things, you'll find that the English is very perfect. Kenya located in East Africa. Just hear that English. Kenya located in East Africa achieved independence from British colonial rule on December 12, 1963. This marked a significant. So when you're in shule pale, no, you have student here, unaenda chat GPT unatafuta kitu hapo, alafu una paste lecture pale without checking the grammar. And if that lecturer gives you a good marks at an A or an B, there is a problem with that lecture. That means mambo yao ya grammar iko very down. So that is what the grammar can do. So nimewafundisha five tools of academic writing. Number one ilikuwa ChatGPT. Number two tukuja kwa zero GPT. What does that do? Ina remove AI content. No, ina check the AI content. Tuwakuja tool number three, inaitangwa Stealth Writer. What does Stealth Writer do? Ina humanize AI content, inaifanya more human, yani inaweka ujinga ndani. So what, another tool, what do we have? We have the paraphrasing tool. Paraphrasing tool ina change the tone, unawezaweka fluent, unawezaweka more synonyms, just to make sure that your work looks nice. Alafu unakuja the fifth, yenye tumesoma, inaitwa Grammarly. So those, then nimewaonyesha sana sana, apart from Grammarly, Grammarly ndio the paid version. Hizo zingine zote ni free, but they are there. But me, I don't like using those premium versions because niko na njia zangu za kutumia hizo zingine free pole hivi. You optimize your profit. So this is the what Grammarly can do. So I'm going to close this tab. Go back here. And okay, so as I was saying before, we are treating two things, that is academic writing and article writing. So vitu zenye tumekapa saizi, there are tools that are used in academic tools. Without those tools, you cannot write anything. Uwezi hata ushinde hapo the whole day, uwezi fanya. Because uwezi chukua dictionary, unaenda kuangalia dictionary, unasoma kama hiyo word iko sawa, una assuming you have a project yenye nataka uandike 10,000 words. So you must use this, you must use those tools. Hakuna mali nimetype na keyboard yangu na utanes kidogo kidogo. I'm still going to teach you how to type, how to paraphrase the manual way ile tulikuwa tunatumia kitambo, and still remove the AI content, because in article writing nayo we don't use these tools, because article writing tunatumianga kwa websites. So website ni ile unaendanga www, huko ndio sasa articles zinatumikanga sana sana. Article, we don't use them for scholarly works. Article tunatumianga more so in business. So umeenda pale kwa Google Chrome yako, kama hapa, uka search, benefits of eating apples. Yani wewe umefikiria wewe ukae maisha soft life uanze kukula apple sasa, ukasema waje sasa nikajue benefits. Ukaenda ukasema sasa benefit of eating apples. Sasa hii umeenda hapo ukasema sasa 7 reasons why apples are good. Ukisoma hii unaanza kusomea hapo, oh sijui bla 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 bla, are apples healthy? Unaenda inaambiwa iko na antioxidant, fiber, this is all propaganda. Don't believe those stuffs. I told you Google sometimes inadanganya. Health benefit, I will prove that why Google lies. Stabilizing blood sugar, oh sijui low cholesterol, hizo vitu zote. Nimekuambia articles they are for business. Na nikikwambia na kudanganya, articles zinaandikangwa to promote a brand. So what is a brand? A brand is a reputation of an organization. That is why ukienda kwa Google ukisearch kitu inakupeleka to a certain website. So tukikuja hapa kwa hii nini? Kwa hii article, this article, hii article utapata ni mtu mwenye akona website, ameweka hii article. Hii website inaitwa Cleveland Clinic. So mtu amefungua clinic yake, akafungua website ya clinic yake, kwenye mtakuwa mnaenda kusearch information about that clinic. Lakini kuna kitu moja tunaitanga search engine optimization, that is not Greek, it is not Arabic, it is not French, it is English. Search engine optimization inakuanga ukiwa na website yako pale, you need people to visit that website. So what you do, unaandikanga articles, a lot of articles. Kama ni article ya Ministry of Health of Kenya, let me use something yenye utaelewa. Ministry of Health, Nairobi. So, wako na their website. They want Kenyans, once they search information pale kwa Google, inawapeleka kwa website yao, and then you go and one of the services nazo pale. So, mtu wa Ministry of Health ataenda andike article, or they will hire somebody, aende andike article awaambie pale, benefits of taking, let's assume just a drug, ARV. uende useme pale these are the benefits why we should be taking ARVs. Uende unasoma pale article, unasoma pale article, unasoma pale article, but at the end of the day, after umesoma hiyo article, you have visited that website and you have seen a service there, and your website, your article you umesoma, it can make you have a purchasing thought. Uende useme, hey, why is niende kanunue ida? Nikanunue ida. So that is the work of articles. So articles, they're not academic. They are used most of by the business, and the market for articles is very huge. So you'll find people with the website. They need people to write for them articles. These articles, unaziandika, they are very simple. Kama unaona huyu mtu alilipo kuandika 7 reasons why apples are good. Akaandika vitu zake, akaandika, akananganya, akananganyana, akananganyana. So the format of articles and academic writing are very different. So you are very privileged, because mimi time nilikuwa nasoma hii kitu, I was only taught academic writing, and then nikaenda nika learn article by myself. So mimi nitawafundisha some basics of articles, how to you write those articles. I will teach you the importance of these articles, venye zinafanya kazi, vitu kama hizo, so that I can give you those skills when you mnataka maybe to go into article writing, because article writing is good. Kuna watu wanaandikanga about they are called bloggers, eh? So watu watu kwa wengi ni bloggers. Even watumi TikTok na such Twitter platform, they use the website to make sure the information inapatikana. Utapata watu wanaandika lifestyle articles, wengine wanaandika health articles, wengine wanaandika financial articles, wengine wanaandika so many things. So for me, that is the end of today's lesson. When you wameingia hapa leo, I hope you have learned something that will change the course of your perception on academic writing. It is very simple if you are taught by the right person and you use the right approach. Hii kitu nikiwafunza hiyo mwezi moja ikiisha mtakuwa mmeiva sana, yani utakuwa unashangaa. So and I told you most of the people wenye niliongea na wao nilikuwa nawaambia at least with me I'm showing you practical examples ya venye unafaa ufanye. I will show you how you can open this academic writing accounts. Those are locals. Nikawaambia kuna watu walikuwa wanauliza, do you sell accounts? No, we don't sell accounts. This is because organization yetu, it is not based on those things. Peter will share you a link of our website here so that you can see the services that we have. In fact, we are like marketing consultants. We also work with TVET institutions. So many things. We teach digital marketing, because digital marketing, again, it is another course on itself that you can stay at home and gain some money from it. So we do a lot of things as an organization. So to your Kwanza, we are not scammers. We are not here to take your money just like that. Whatever you will pay for this course, it will be valuable. It will be worth your money. And to Mwambia, because this is the first time we are doing academic writing, we are going to give you a very good rate so that you can refer to us and you can maybe help us in developing our brand further. So that is all for today. Maybe Peter want to add something else as we wind up the meeting.
Yes, thank you very much, Edwin, for the great presentation you have given us. I hope now the people who have attended, some have been experiencing issues with their internet, I want to assume. So if you have joined us, I think since the beginning, you have seen that our trainer indeed has a background in whatever he's trying to teach you. And this recording will be uploaded on our YouTube channel. So in case there's an issue, you can just go and check it out. And we request you guys to find, if possible, find a laptop. If you need assistance in terms of acquiring one, we can pinpoint you to the correct direction, but at least have a laptop, because it's a great tool that will assist you in the whole process. So before we wind up, I will take just one or two questions. In case you have questions, just one or two, then we cross. Stanley, maybe you can go.
My question is this: do you give certificates after training?
Well, if it's a certificate for participation, that one you can design something. I will design something to show that indeed we trained you in this. But it's one thing you should know is that this will be just a certificate of participation. It will not be a qualification that you can use maybe to further your education, or you can use it, let's say, for any other activities apart from showing that you underwent a training for the academic writing. Any other question? Okay, if there is no other question, I want to thank you once more for coming, and I hope to see you tomorrow as we dive deeper into this academic writing. And at the end of the day, we want you to get value in terms of knowledge, and understand that this, if you're learning, this one you can also use it, let's say, in your academic, the moment if you are in campus, college, or wherever you might be, you'll use this knowledge a lot, is also in your studies. So it's not even just about academic writing, it will also assist you in terms of your research and the rest. So having no further ado, I would like to see you tomorrow. The recording will be there. And thank you. Santeni.
And then we'll talk some other time. And guys, please, things I promise you, right now you must not figure out the real importance of this course. Of your life, you'll sit down and then you'll see the sweetness of maybe doing something on your own. Asanteni sana, have a lovely evening.